Hi, I'm Viktor, Simulation Specialist at PLM Group. In this video I will show a simple setup of a structural strength analysis of a part with Structural Designer on the 3DEXPERIENCE platform. So in this case we start with a SolidWorks model. I will go to the 3DEXPERIENCE task pane and save it to the platform, as it's not saved yet. So I'll just do the save and let it go through with the normal save procedure. When that is done, I will mark the part in the tree and go to the compass, and I will find the right app. So we're going to look at Structural Designer. So if I click on the role here, we'll see that there is one app. So Linear Structure Validation, that's the app we're going to use. If I go back, I can also search for it. And click Linear Structure Validation. And in a moment, the interface will open. And there we are. We're open and we are in the simulation app. So we have the choice here of a structural, which is a linear, static, elastic analysis, linear buckling, eigenfrequency, or thermal. So we're just going to go with the structural analysis because we're going to do a strength analysis of this little bracket. So let's name it like this. All right. So the setup is being done here. If you can't see all the buttons, you can right click and switch between showing just the icons. Right click again and add the text as well, so it's easier to find your way around. So we'll start by applying the material. I'll go to the material palette. And I'll search some appropriate material. So it's going to be just a simple steel. And these are materials that are already added in the tenant or in the workspace. So let's pick one of these and we'll check in the simulation tab here, simulation properties, that we have simulation material properties. So we'll go here, use the apply tool and just click on the part and close. I can now close this one and we can proceed with the setup. Let's do a mesh, fix the component, and then apply some load and then just run the simulation. So I'm going to the mesh tab here. So all the meshing is done with the mesh specification tool here. So we go in there and we have some default element size suggested. We have some elements in a hole which will apply to fillets as well. So we can just generate the mesh and see if that's acceptable. Yeah, we also have the opportunity to add some local refinements here, which you can also do from the toolbar, from the action bar down here. Okay. Then we go to the boundary condition tab down here. So let's fix the four bottom holes. Let's use the hinge. So we'll click the hinge and try to put them in the holes here. If it's a little bit tricky to select them here, we can hide the mesh. So if I go to the mesh tab, we can hide and show the mesh here. So then it's easier to select the holes. So back to boundary conditions, I'll go to the hinge and fix this hole. And they should be in separate conditions here. So okay, and then I can double click on the hinge down here. And then just pick the next one, click okay. Third one, okay. Fourth one, okay. And then cancel. And now we have the four symbols here. Then let's add a load as well to the top hole here. So we go into loads, we can add the regular force, we can also put a remote force, which we'll do here. which acts at an offset location. So let's use that one and we'll put it in the middle of the hole. And then we get some coordinates here, which is the center position of the hole, which we can adjust if we want to. And we can toggle that on and off here in case we need to. So I want to put the load at an oblique angle, maybe like this. So we can use these tools to align the coordinate system here. We can align it with the global system, which maybe it's not correct here. We can align it according to some geometry. So I click this one and click the hole. Let me get this back. To put them at an angle, we can use the rotating tool here, which is active with this button here. Okay, so let's rotate it 45 degrees around the y-axis, 45, click, and now we can apply the load here. 500 newtons, okay. And there it is. How do I get an overview of this then now? What did I do? What have I set up? Well, I can use the assistant, which you can do from the beginning. That can help you as a guide through the setup, where we see what is necessary. Setup, materials, connections, boundary conditions, and the loads. We can also use the feature manager, which is what I recommend. Right-click feature manager, and yeah, here we have what we created, the force. We can go in and edit it from here. If I press F3 on my keyboard, I get the tree here. I get the simulation that we named, the model, so the part that comes from SolidWorks in this case, but I cannot edit anything from here in this app in Structural Designer. So this will just show you the structure, but it's not really useful, and it's better to use the feature manager or assistant to get an overview. So I'm going to hide that again, and then we're just going to run the simulation and see what we get. I'm going to hit save, so Control S. The saving is also possible from here. And then we're just going to run the simulation. Here it's done in the result tab. Go there and simulate. So I get the option here of running it locally or on the cloud. I have a few cloud cores included here, which I can use. If I want to use a lot of cores, I have to use my tokens here, which are additional tokens. This is a tiny simulation, so I can probably use my local computer, and let's just run it on 2 cores. And it will run. Simulation is completed. We can close this window and we can look at the results. So we get the displacement here. We get the various stress components. We can check the von Mises stress, and we can find max and mean locations. I can click here. I can use the tool to find the max value down here. We can hide those, and then we can also look at the factor of safety in the list, factor of safety. And then to make this make sense, we can play with the numbers here. So I can double click here and adjust the scale just to visualize it. We have the minimum of 1.12, and let's assume that we want to have a safety factor of at least 3. So then we can see the areas here that are gray are out of range, and the colored areas are then areas where we have a safety factor between 1.12 and 3. Okay, one last thing in the results. To look at the reaction forces, we can use the resultant sensor. Let's open up the feature manager and check what we got. Under the sensor tab, we have the total reaction force here. But to find out what's happening at the fixtures, we can use the resultant sensor. And we can create one for the boundary conditions, for example, for the first hinge. And then just look in the global system. And okay. So it's located at the center location, but this will tell us the force components and the reaction force at this boundary condition that we chose. Thanks for watching.